All right, guys, so today we are going to go over Zumed's Environmental Control Center. Relatively new unit, they've had it out for a little while. I'm sure you're familiar with different types of thermostats for controlling heating. This takes it definitely one step above and gives you control of not only heat, humidity, cooling, dehumidifying, and it works great. So we're gonna go through all of the parts that we have here today. So first off, this is the main portion of the unit. Comes with this nice handy dandy little base, so you can mount it next to your tank, keep cords nice and controlled. Before I go start putting in all of the probes that comes with it, I'm just gonna kind of walk through what each of the plugs do. So this first one here, as you can see kind of on the front, is gonna control a heating device, whether it be like a ceramic heat emitter or a heat lamp or deep infrared heat projector, under tank heaters, things like that. Now with the second plug here, you can also run it for other heating devices, just the same as number one, plug number one, but it also has the ability to run a cooling unit. So whether you wanna run a fan, or you could also run the Reptile chiller with it, and that's gonna help heat or cool your tank depending on what you wanna do with that one. Number three here is gonna be able to run a humidifier. It will run things like the Reptile fogger, and increase humidity in your cage. You can also plug it in to run as a dehumidifier and run a fan that's gonna actually help clear out the air in the cage. Whichever way you do it, you can just set it up in different modes. Then here on the back side, these are all of your timers. Timer plug number four is just going to be a direct timer, so off on timer. The next two timers are gonna be your day and night timers. You can run a daylight to simulate daylight, and you can run a red bulb or blue bulb for nighttime viewing, and it will automatically flip those for you as you see fit. So whatever you want to do with your schedule. Now we'll go ahead with what you see here on top. Now there is a temp one, a temp two. Those correlate with plugs one and two. Then you have humidity one, which correlates to your humidity plug, and then a plug here for your controller. They're nice and easy. Just have kind of like your standard headphone jack here with the probe on the end, and they're just gonna plug directly in. And then these all come with a 9-foot cord, so you can actually run those anywhere into your cage as long as it's sitting next to it, and get those proper temps and humidities that you want and go from there. Now this last one is made to hook directly into the controller unit. So we'll go ahead and open this one up, and then this actually runs directly to your controller. Plugs right there in, and then this does come with some Velcro that you can adhere to the side of your tank, front of your tank, your cabinet, whatever you have it sitting on, and it'll go there. Now we're gonna go ahead and plug in the unit so you can see actually how the controller works. It does have a built-in temperature alarm, so if we hear some screaming right off the bat, you will know why. So this is the fancy dancy unit. Now, right off the bat, it is preset for some temperatures, but those temperatures aren't necessarily going to be what you want. So to set these guys, we're gonna go ahead and we press the little socket button here. And you can see here that the little socket there is blinking, socket one. And that's gonna be off of your socket one temperature, and that's gonna be your dimming heat source. Then what you will do is you'll go down to the list button here, and they call it the row button, and that's where you're gonna program the day set value. As you can see here, day set. It's flashing right next there for 86. We're gonna say we set this up for a ball python, so we want that basking spot, we'll say right at 95. Then we hit that row button again, it'll give us our nighttime set temp. Personally, I like to do about a 10 degree temperature drop with most of mine, and so you can set that up to 85. And then we gotta program the alarm. So I wanna know, you know, I like to keep mine relatively within range, and I feel like 5 degrees is gonna be a good range. So if it gets outside of that temperature by 5 degrees, especially with this unit, because it can keep pretty accurate, we go ahead and set there. And then when that's done, we just hit it again. And so we are all set. And then as you can see here, this little 47%, what that is doing is that's telling you how much heat is being transferred, or how much power is being controlled to your heating device. So it's gonna continue going up because we have nothing on, but this way it's a proportional heat And so it's only adding 51% at this time of energy to your bulb, so it's only going at half power. For socket two, we hit this socket button again. We go to socket one, then socket two. Socket two is now flashing. Now I have it on heat here currently, but if we hit this button, it'll actually fluctuate between heat and you can actually turn it onto cool mode if you want to. So it flips between cool and heat by pressing your up and down arrows. So we're gonna switch it over to heat just because we're not trying to turn on a cooler on the ball python. Unless your house is really hot, you might need to, but most people aren't gonna have to do that. So we set that, we're on heat, click here. Now we have our day set. I'm gonna leave that set at 75, keeps that cool side at 75 for me. It's not gonna really let it get much lower than that. And then we'll hit it one more time. We'll just do a 5 degree temperature drop. We don't really want it to drop much below 70 at night over there. And then this next one's interesting. This is the differentiation, or the differential on it. If I set it at 75, this allows it to know without any problem drop anywhere between 70 and 80 and still be within range. If you want it to stay right at 75 all the time, you can just turn this down to a zero and it keeps it at 75. So there's no natural fluctuation. Then we hit that one more time and that's gonna be our alarm range. Now again, I'm gonna set this down to 5 just so I know if this temperature starts going out of crazy, 5 degrees can definitely make it, or any more than 5 degrees can make a difference. So now we're gonna go to socket 3. Now socket 3, you have that availability to run humidity or a dehumidifier. Again, you can switch between the two with the arrows just like you did with the heat or cooling. Right now we're gonna put it on humidity because we wanna make sure we're keeping a decent humidity in there. And I'm gonna run that humidity at, hit that button. Now we have the daytime humidity set. I'm gonna keep it right at about 60%. That's a good humidity for where I'm setting it up. And if you wanted to change it though, you just use those arrows again and you can change that humidity. But we're gonna leave it at 60. And then nighttime humidity, it's currently set at 50. I'm just gonna go ahead and bump that back up to 60 as well. Then the next one that we hit that again. Again with that differentiation, I'm fine with a 3 degree differentiation on that. And then we will go with our alarm, and that one, I'm gonna set that alarm a lot lower. So if it fluctuates, we'll just do that one by 10% humidity change. Now this isn't necessarily for any particular animal. I know I've said certain ones, but this is just gonna show you guys how to do it. All right, so now we're gonna go to the next socket 4. We'll hit the socket button. It will kick on to 3, 4. All right, so socket 4 on. I'm gonna make socket 4 come on. We're gonna have it kick on at 9 a.m. Then we are going to hit that button again. Don't need to worry about the minutes on there. We will go to the off time and we will set that for 9 p.m. Now, it does have a built-in feature where you can run that timer twice in the day. So if you wanna turn, say you put a mister on it and you wanna run that mister for, you know, a minute in the morning, turn it off, and then a minute at night, it has that where you can build that in. But we're not gonna worry about that second timer on here today because we have no need for it. But you would set that exactly the same way. So we go down to socket 5. To program that one. Now socket 5 and socket 6 are your day night timers. So if we hit socket 5, it's going to go on at 8 o'clock. That's gonna turn on your daylights. So 8 o'clock AM, we hit that one more time. That's gonna go to socket 6. Now socket 6 goes on at 8 PM. So when socket 6 turns on, it automatically turns off socket 5. And then when socket 6 is running, it will turn on socket 5 in the morning and shut off socket 6. Might sound kind of confusing, but I swear it makes sense. Other than that, now you have it programmed on. So what you'll want to do is go ahead and plug in all of your attachments into the main unit here and run those into your tank and just make sure everything's going well. I do recommend having this set up and going before you put the animal in, just in case there's any issues. We don't want to harm the animal in any way. So we want to let it run just to make sure that everything's working properly, and then go from there. If you guys do have any questions about it, definitely just send us over a message, give us a call, whatever. We would be happy to help you guys out.